Good day, everybody. Thank you for the interest in my presentation, which will be about using FME for cost calculations in broadband infrastructure expansion. As Gerhard already introduced me, I can go quite fast through all of these points on the slide. So I am a service engineer at Axman Geoinformation and also a product manager of checkgeodata.net, which is a product developed by us and which is an online tool for quality insurance for geodata. And I also participate in the SAFe software certification program, so where I obtained all of the certifications like professional, FME server certified, and FME certified trainer. And in that role as a certified trainer, I also performed like probably 100 FME training courses and workshops during the last 8 years. The company where I'm working for is Axman Geoinformation, or as I did the same mistake, actually that's the name, but it's Axman Geoinformation. It was founded in 1999, and it was actually one of the first SAFe partners worldwide. So actually the first user conference for SAFe software took place in Vienna and was organized by our founder, Axel Axman. Currently we are SAFe Gold partner, and of course a certified reseller for Austria. We've got 5 employees and about 120 customers. And because of the long partnership with SAFe Software, we are the number one competence center for FME technology in our region. The Axman Geoinformation belongs to Aram Data. So actually Aram Data is our mother company. We are 100% daughter. Aram Data was founded in 1985 and is a main Austrian software developer for survey products and survey software products and GIS products. There are 70 employees working on these products, and actually Aram Data is the number one developer for survey software in Austria. The main surveying products are Aram Geo and GeoMapper. And besides of this, there's also Aram Data geospatial division, and they are producing their own GIS systems, and the main GIS products are GeoDesktop and GeoApp. And Aram Data applications is used for infrastructure, for authority management, and for engineering companies. And all of our three divisions belong to a kind of an umbrella organization, which is Aram Data Group. And all of our divisions are represented in the logo, where the colors red means Aram Data Survey, green is Aram Data Geospatial, and blue is Aram Data Geodata Management, which actually is Axman Geoinformation. The project I will talk about the next 20 minutes was for one of our most important customers, which is a main Austrian telecommunication provider. And the background of this project was the announcement of the Austrian government to substitute the development of new high-speed internet infrastructure in remote areas, and to substitute this with funds in a volume of 1 billion euros. The name of the project, of the governmental project, was Broadband Austria 2020, and it was based on a Broadband Strategy 2020 and was developed by the Austrian Department for Transport and Technology. And the main task of the project was to promote their development and the improvement of high-speed and next-generation networks in rural and underdeveloped regions of Austria. And the goal was to achieve an Austrian-wide high-speed internet access before 2020, and that means that 98% of the Austrian population should have an internet which is faster than 100 megabit per second before 2020. And to achieve this goal, the Austrian government was willing to pay to invest 1 billion euros for that. I don't want to be too detailed about the governmental project, but just the slogan, which is also a kind of the organization of this project, and that was one goal, three programs, and three stages. So let's take a look at the programs regarded to our customer. The first program was about access. That means the spatial extensions of existing NGA networks with the goal to increase the coverage of high-speed internet access. Then the backhaul part of the project, which was the enhancement of access networks and connection of standalone solutions to the core network, which actually is the backbone. And there was also the empty conduits part of the project. And that means to have a better coordination in the future in laying empty pipes during communal civil engineering works, just to prepare already some infrastructure if there is the need to connect some communities to high-speed internet access. This is the part of the project we will cover in this presentation. It's only the first one. So that means the access part, which means the improvement of existing access networks by our customer. So let's take a look what we have. So we have 1 billion euros on the one side, and on the other side we have FME. So why not to use this great tool to grab as much of this money as we can? Let's start with the workflow, how we have done this, or how we have tried to get to grab this money. So the first point was done prior to the FME works following after that. And a special software called ZARU was used to calculate a hypothetical network consisting of ARUs and the connections to the existing network. ARU means access remote unit, and that's actually the Austrian term for the DSLAM. And based on these calculations, based on the data resulted from this point, we could start our FME works. And the first part of the FME work was to evaluate the IRUs, if they are eligible or not. That means if they are covered by the governmental project or not. And only the eligible ARUs were considered in the next point where we made the cost calculations. So that means how much the planned network will cost our customer. Last but not least, we have to visualize planned networks, and we also had to visualize the estimated bandwidth in that regions, in that communities, where we want to implement the projects. So here you can see the result of the first part. So that was done before FME. And the ZARU software calculated this networks here. You can see the red dots. The red dots are actually the IRUs, which looks something like this. And inside these boxes, you have the DSLAM devices, which actually connect the copper cables coming from the customer sites to the high-speed internet network. All of these IRUs must be connected to the MDF. The MDF is the main distribution frame, and the MDF is the central point of an access network. You can see the MDFs, that are the green points on the particular access networks. So all of these new planned IRUs, the red dots, must have a connection to the green one. So the green lines are already existing infrastructure, and the red lines are projects that must have been done to connect the new IRUs with the MDF. So having having this data, we finally could start our FME works, and the first FME work was to check if an IRU is eligible or not. And one criteria of the eligibility was if the IRU is located in an eligible area. The eligible areas are here green colored, and we created these eligible areas using an official 100 on 100 meter raster provided by the Austrian Department for Statistics. So by the way, the same raster we have used to create the bandwidth mapping, it's the last point of the project. So, but that was not the only criteria for the eligibility of an IRU device. There were some more, like for example, the technology which the IRUs have been implemented, or the percentage of final user that will have an high-speed internet access. And to check if these IRUs are eligible or not, we have created this workspace here. So actually, our workspace that I am showing now in this presentation are child workspaces, which were run by a workspace runner in the current in the parent workspace. So we have done this because the input data are lists of counties and access networks which are located in a particular foundation region. So actually what we got here from this creator are codes of networks, of access networks, and we made here some database joins because, as you can imagine, our customer is a big telecommunication provider. They have a lot of databases, so we have to add some additional data on our IRUs. And at this point, we have a data flow of IRU devices. Because of the additional data we added in the step I showed before, we could estimate the bandwidth of this device using a specific formula. And we then grouped these IRUs to different to seven different bandwidth classes, where one means very slow internet and seven means high-speed internet. And we also used these classes for the bandwidth mapping at the last step. So having all this data, we finally could calculate if our device is eligible or not. There were some more criteria. I will not go into detail anymore, but this is the result of the first step. As you can see, we have the ID of the IRU devices, and here at the last column, you can see if the device is eligible or not. And only the eligible devices were considered in the next step, where we made the cost calculations. So this is the workspace done for that. And that was not a single process, but in a repetitive one. I will just explain it, why it was a repetitive process, where we did till maximum three iterations. It starts like the first workspace. We have here some database joins. Especially, we joined the evaluation data with our IRUs here. And very important is this inline query here. So where we do, first of all, we join the evaluation data, but more important is the cross join here at the bottom, where we made cross join all IRUs with the MDFs of the network. So as a result, we get as many MDFs as IRUs we have at the same network. Why do we need this crazy stuff? I will just show you in the next few slides. Here we just do some preparation of the line networks to make the cost calculations. It's like topology cleaning and something like that. And here you can see the result, not the result, but a temporary result. This is one access network. And you see the green dot is the MDF, and actually we've got already as many green dots just overlaying each other as red dots, that means as IRUs. So, but any MDF got the information of an IRU device. So we need this because we do the cost calculation here. where we first of all connect each IRU device with one MDF. And as the next result, we get a weird feature like this here. So we have one connection from one IRU device to its counterpart MDF device. So we need these connections for a specific transformer because there's one FME transformer which needs these features as an input. And the name of the FME transformer is the shortest pathfinder. And the shortest pathfinders here in relation with the special relator are actually the backbone of our cost calculations. So the cost calculations are based on the distance from one IRU to the MDF, which we calculated in the length calculator, of course. So what we get after this step is something like this. We have one connection from any IRU device to the MDF. And we use the special relator to calculate how often one section is used as a root. So as you look maybe at the device at the top of the slide, so you can see there's a long connection. And when you just see the go down the blue line, you see that to build the first section of the blue line, there are four devices that will benefit of it. So we can divide the cost of the first section between four IRUs. The next one, it's just built, and three devices will benefit. And the last one, the last long section, is only built to support the last device. And now you probably got an idea why there was more than one iteration for the calculation. Because our customer made a threshold. That means a limit how much a device much can maximally cost. So if one device was more expensive than this limit, so maybe our customer said, no, we don't want to build this device. And then we had to remove this device from our database. But when we remove one device from our database, this has effects on the other devices. So because the first section of the blue line is not divided by four devices anymore, but only by three. So the section will be more expensive. And we did it as long as our customer actually was satisfied. And I can say that after three iterations, all devices had has been below the threshold as our customer decided. So here we do the final calculations because we had to provide the calculations county-wise, as the counties itself will also be charged for the network improvements. So we did here some mergers, some overlays, some group buys, and as an result of the first iteration, we got something like that here. You can see the again the number of the or the IDs of the IRU devices, and here on the last column, you can see the price of this device. So as you can, let's assume that our customer said the limit for one device is maybe 500,000 euro. So you can see here three of the IRU's devices are higher than 500,000 euro. So we have to remove them from the database. We made another run, and after the second iteration, there's one device that became higher than the 500,000 euro decided by our customer. So finally, after the third iteration, all devices have been below this limit, and this actually was the result of this point. Yeah, after we had these calculations, our customer finally could apply for the projects at the governmental organization responsible for the funds. And for that, we had to create KML files to show the estimated bandwidth coverage. And as I already told you before, we used the 100-on-100 meta raster, and we overlaid it with the IRUs, made some calculations, and the final result were KML files like this here, where you can see the 100-100 meter raster cells and the 7 different bandwidth classes, where the red ones mean high-speed internet and the white ones mean, okay, the internet will be not so fast at these regions here. Yeah, let's summarize what we have done. We have evaluated the IRUs using FME. We have calculated the costs, and we have mapped the estimated coverage. So, and as a conclusion, after this project, we could say FME is just awesome. Yeah, we already knew it before, but we were not sure if we can use FME for operations that are very crucial and where the stakes are very high, and for calculations that will be made for very strategical decisions. But after this project, we had the result, yes, we can use the FME even for such critical projects. So if you are interested at our work, you can just write me an email. You can see here. And for now, thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Thomas, for your presentation. I think we still have a couple of minutes for questions.
Do you have any figures regarding the number of ARRU devices and the time of calculation of your process on the region or?
Actually, I am not sure because it was all over Austria, and as you can see, there are like 15 devices per access network, and I think that's like 1,500 access networks, so it's a lot of devices. And yeah. Yeah, to calculate the cost for the whole Austrian region, there were like 8 hours running of FME. It was like the evaluation was even a little bit longer. There was like 9-10 hours, and the cost calculation itself were about 8 hours. But it was 1 year, almost 2 years ago, and we used FME 2014 because our customer used still FME 2014. I guess you probably can give me right. 2017 would make it quite faster. Yes. <it's laughs>
Mm-hmm. You different wording. Is it about coax versus light fiber net?
Yeah, it's actually, but the terms in Austria are quite different. Yeah.
Because I'm in the phase of this iteration, let's say.
Yeah.
I now have a complete map of plant of my working area where each street actually depending on what is there. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I can just tell you a little bit about the FME works, as I am not the telecommunication expert, but we have a telecommunication group at our company, so if you have any questions, you can just ask me and I will forward it to the guys. Yeah. No, actually, it's just a first calculation, just to give the management a rough idea how much everything would cost. So we made like there was like a digging meter, so we just assumed it's like 15 euro per digging meter, and so it's quite rough. But you know, it's a first impression, just to decide when we make it or not. Mm-hmm.
Similar workflows, FME being applied to expansion of these types of networks in Italy, in Austria now, in Ireland, Belgium, you were talking about, I believe, anybody else, well, in the US, I'm sure. So it's quite interesting that FME is being applied to the same problem, really, lot of different places, so it's cool.
Regarding the cost evaluation, do you relate the cost, is it absolute, or do you relate the cost depending on the number of persons that will be reached?
It's, yeah. Actually, the final decision was on number on the supported locations, but this cost here were per device. So it was just the first calculation, and then we made another calculations, but not using FME, just to show the management how many how many locations will be supported by these devices, and if it's still in the strategic interest of our customer or not. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you.